Hey everyone, welcome to another Adobe Illustrator tutorial. My name is Andre from Adogovie. Today I would like to show you how to draw this image. I start with a new document, go to File and click New. And I use 340mm by 210mm. And click OK. So next, you have to create a rectangle. Choose Rectangle tool and create a big rectangle. So this is the rectangle for the background. Choose the color, non-color for stroke, and I start with dark red color. So these are the default color swatches. So and I use this red color. So next, open the group and duplicate the rectangle. Click and drag this layer down to the new layers button. So next, I change the color for the second rectangle and please open the color panel. And now I like to change the color, all three sliders together. So hold down the control key and click and move one of the sliders. And now I'm going to use the eraser tool. So make a double click and set the size very big to 80 points. Click OK. So select the rectangle and erase in the middle. So you can erase a little bit more. So next, you have to make a copy of the second rectangle. Drag this down to the new layers button. And now I'm going to change again the color. Hold down the control key and move the slider. So that's fine. And now again with the eraser tool, erase. So that's okay. So please lock the first rectangle. So if you like, you can make it a little bit darker. So lock the background rectangle. And now I'm going to use the blend tool. So choose the blend tool and now click on the light rectangle and on the darker rectangle. So now you have to open the blend tool, go to objects, blend, and click on blend options. So and choose by spacing, choose specified steps and set 3. Enable the preview. So that's fine. Click OK. So now I'm going to make some variations. And I'm going to open the blend layer. And I start with a dark layer. So now I'm going to use the warp tool. So before you start with the warp tool, it's important to open the options, make a double click on the warp tool and I use this warp options, so enable both. You can try and play a little bit with the options, so but I disable both options and click OK. So if you hold down the Alt key, you can change the size. Hold the Alt key and move your mouse. And now with a light rectangle. So if you are happy with the result, select the whole blend group and go to Objects, Blend, and click on Expand. And now we have new layers. All the colors and objects are converted in new layers. So if you like, you can change some of these layers. So for example, I'd like to change the light layer. So select the rectangle and continue with the warp tool. So if you like, you can change warp tool options. So enable the simplify. And Illustrator remove, delete some of the anchor points. So if you wish, you can use a warp tool in all layers. So deselect all and so deselect and now make it very big. Or can change the brush size, hold down the Alt key and make it very small. So if you want to scale all layers, so I recommend you to use the Lasso tool and select all together and now use this free transform tool. So you can find the free transform tool behind the Puppet Warp tool. And now hold down Alt and Shift. Or you can use it without Alt and Shift. Or you can use only the Alt key. And you can move it with the arrow keys down a little bit to the left. So that's fine. I'm finished with the basic shapes. And now I'd like to create swatches, color swatches from the selected shapes. So select the whole group and now go to the swatches panel, down to the go to the toolbar on top and click on that button, new color group, and create from selected artwork. That's fine. And click OK. And we have new swatches. So I'd like to arrange my colors. So left, dark, and click on the swatch and move it to the left. So that's fine. So next I'm going to ungroup layer 1. Inside the layer 1 we have the rectangle and a group. So you have to ungroup it. Click on this little circle to select the whole group. And now go to objects and click on ungroup. So next please deselect all. And now I continue with brushes. So first I'm going to open my brushes set. So all these brushes are available on my website, dogubi.com. And I start with the summer brushes. And like to draw with this brush. Next, choose the paintbrush tool. Make a double click. Check the options. So I use this position. Click OK. And I like to draw with this, the second dark red color. And this dark red color is my first red inside this color group. So choose this red, apply it to the stroke color. And so next is important to create a group. So you have two options to make a group. First, move these two layers down. So these are the three layers I like to group. So the first option, you can go to objects and group this, or you can go to the layers panel options and collect it in new layer. It's very important to use this options, collect in new layer, because if you group it, so you have to select these three layers, click on this small circle by hold the shift key. So if you group this, it's fine, but if you like to draw inside this group, it's not possible. So you can select this group and choose a brush and draw new lines. Illustrator, create new layers not in this group. You can see new stroke are over all the other groups. So you have to move this layer into the group. So it's not the right way. So make undo. And undo group. So the second options, you have to select the layers, not the objects, the three layers, and now go to the layers panel options and click on collect in new layer. So, and you will find the three layers inside this new group, or the layer 2. And if you like to draw inside this group, you have to select layer 2 And when you draw new lines, you can see the new lines are inside this group. So delete. I'd like to delete this four layers, select and click on this button, delete. So now I'd like to group the second. So this and this color are the second color into the swatches color group. So I choose this color and first I use the same brush. So and now move this. Now select both layers and go to the layers panel options, collect a new layer and make the same with the other. Oh, sorry. So next I like to draw inside this group. So you have not choose specifically one of these colors and choose and search the group. So hold down the control key and click on this path and Illustrator choose automatically layer and the right color. So if you like to draw inside this group, hold down the control key and select this stroke and Illustrator choose automatically this layer and the new color. So and now we can draw some lines. So to move this and like to draw inside this group. So I can choose another brush. So if you choose this stroke, Illustrator select automatically the layer, the color and choose the same brush. So if you like to draw with another brush, you have to click on this stroke, next deselect, or you can choose the shortcut Shift, Control and A. So next choose the brush. With thin stroke. So next I'm continue to create some palm trees and I use another brush set. So I use the palm tree brushes. So next I'm going to create a new layer and lock my basic layers And I'm going to create some palm trees with these brushes. So with these brushes, it's very easy to create a palm tree. So choose a paintbrush tool, and I use black color for stroke. And start with the first brush. Second. So you can change some of the strokes. So select all and move it a little bit up. And last, I use this brush. Oh, sorry. And you have to draw behind. So go to the toolbar on the left side and click on this button, drawing modes, and choose draw behind. And set the stroke width to 0.5. So that's fine. And if you are happy with the palm tree, you have to expand it, select all, and now go to object and click on expand appearance. And next I'd like to change the color. So select and now go to Pathfinder and click on unite. So now you have one shape, and change the color to black. So next I like to modify it a little bit, so I use the warp tool and make it very small. So you can, if you like, you can simplify it, this object. So go to object, path, and click on simplify. So play with the sliders. So that's fine. So next I'm going to unite the palm tree. So first deselect the tramp and now select the whole group. Open the Pathfinder. And click on this button, unite. So that's fine. So in the meantime, I've created with the same brushes several palm trees. So the next step is to check the color. It's very important to set the color to black. So open the colors panel and select the palm trees and click on this black. So that's fine. So next it's very important to group my first palm tree. So select and group it. So now we have each tree in one group. And now I start to copy the palm trees and paste it into my red image. So I start with this, select the group, go to edit and copy. So now make the palm trees invisible. And now I'd like to paste the palm tree into my first layer. So select the layer and go into edit and click on paste. So now you have to apply the right color. So make the edges invisible, go to view and click on hide edges, or you can use the short key. So you can scale it a little bit. So next I use this tree. Copy and paste it in the same group. And use the same color. So that's fine. So next I'd like to paste it in the second group. And choose the right color. That's fine. So you can copy this tree and paste this tree in the new, the other group. So deselect all and apply right color. So that's fine. So, and now last palm trees, copy. So, and move the palm trees on top. And I'd like to flip this horizontal, so open the transform panel and click on flip horizontal. So that's fine. So now I use for these two palm trees another option. So first make a copy of these two palm trees, select both and drag down to the new layers button. So first two palm trees, choose the same color as the big rectangle. So, and the copies, I'm going to apply a gradient. So first apply the same color and now open the gradient panel and, oh, sorry. You have to use for dark color. The same rectangle color, so that's fine. And now I'm going to modify the gradient, select both trees, and now choose gradient tool and drag your mouse. Hide the edges, so that's fine. So next, please move the palm trees with the gradient in a new layer. So create a new layer. So first, change the drawing mode to draw normal, and now create a new layer. And now select two palm trees with the gradients and drag into the new layer. That's fine. And now I'm going to apply a shadow. So select my first group, click on this little circle, and now go to Effects, Stylize, and choose Drop Shadow. So I use the color. So, but I'm going to change the color. So that's fine. And I set, or I change the color a little bit lighter. So that's fine. Set 2 millimeters and the blur. Two points. Okay. So now select the other layer. Again. Effect, Stylize, and Drop Shadow. So now we have the same settings. So if you wish, you can set the blur. change the offset. So if you hold down the control key, you can change it in very small steps. And now the last two palindromes make the same drop shadow. Okay, and open the groups. And make the trunks invisible. So that's fine. So next I'm going to make a clipping mask to hide the shadow outside. So create a rectangle, choose the rectangle tool, and create a big rectangle. So make sure that the rectangle are on top, not inside the palm tree groups. So this is my rectangle, and now deselect all and select layer 1, the main group, and now click on this button, make release clipping mask. So next I'm going to modify the palm trees inside the groups. So lock the groups, and I'd like to move the palm trees inside my first group. So it's helpful if you hide the edges, and now so if you can use the shift key and the arrow keys if you hold down shift key, you can move it in very big steps. So that's fine. Now the second. Oh, sorry, not the whole group. A new move. So, and last, I'm going to draw inside the groups with my brushes. So I open again my summer brushes. Open the swatches panel. So I'm going to draw in my first group with the dark red color. You have to change the color, not the, the stroke color, not the fill color. So undo. That's fine. Now the second group. So, and last, if you are finished, you can change the color. So please unlock all layers and now select the whole group. And now click on Recolor Artwork. You can find this button on the top toolbar, or you can go to Edit, Edit Colors, and click on Recolor Artwork. So now click on Edit and click on this button, Link Harmony Colors. And now you can drag the sliders. That's it, I'm finished. Thanks for watching. If you like this tutorial, please press thumbs up and share it with your friends. If you want to see more of my tutorials, please subscribe my channel. Hope to see you soon.